Thank you, Jenny. The surge in migrant crossings in recent weeks, though, has opened up a political debate. That border in our backyard in Yuma, just today, the mayor confirming two reps from the Department of Homeland Security were here, along with FEMA, the Arizona Department of Emergency Military Affairs, and a rep from the governor's office, as well as the Arizona National Guard. Camila Brunell, though, has reaction tonight from both sides of the aisle.
The numbers are surging, and children are coming alone. That is undisputed, but what to do about it becomes political.
We're doing everything we can to make sure we have facilities that are appropriate for children so that they can be processed quickly and moved to sponsors, families, foster homes.
While the Biden administration looks for shelter space,
there are children in awful conditions right now.
Republicans worried about what could happen in the middle of a pandemic.
They have a screening questionnaire for medical and temperature checks, but other than that, they're not testing for COVID-19.
They're also concerned about the message.
You send the message that the border is not open to anybody to cross. We shouldn't be encouraging minors to come across unaccompanied.
But the White House says the message is clear.
Making sure that we convey the message that the border is not open, that the majority of people will be returned, and that it is not ever a good idea to come in this irregular fashion. But the smuggler's message is very pervasive.
Some lawmakers say they're willing to work in a bipartisan way to address this, but advocates say something needs to be done quickly.
I do think the administration needs to clearly set up a process for dealing with families.
I'm Camila Brunell reporting.
And more than 4,000 unaccompanied children remain in Border Patrol custody at last check on Sunday, according to data obtained by NBC News. And that's about 1,000 more than in just the previous week. Now, they are supposed to detain children for no more than 3 days. But again, Border Patrol is holding them longer because there is next to no space in the Health and Human Services system. FEMA has stepped in to help manage and care for children crossing the border. But tonight, the Homeland Security Secretary acknowledging they are having to work around the clock to manage the situation at the border. Alejandra Mayorkas says, quote, our goal is a safe, legal, and orderly immigration system. He agrees, though, we are on pace to encounter more individuals along the southwest border than we have in the last 20 years. Single adults and families are either sent back to Mexico or put on a plane back to their native country. But this administration is not expelling unaccompanied children. They are held until placed with a sponsor. Now, in more than 80% of cases, the child, sometimes even just 6 or 7 years old, arrives at the border alone, but does have a family member in the United States. The HHS secretary added that because of poverty, high levels of violence and corruption in Mexico and the Northern Triangle countries have really propelled migration into the southwest border for years now. COVID, of course, now an added element with limited space in an already crowded environment. Now, he also said the prior administration completely dismantled the asylum system. The system was gutted, facilities were closed, and they cruelly expelled young children into the hands of traffickers, end quote. So in addition to temporary shelters, there are other short and long-term goals, including legal and safe pathways to reach the United States, as well as investments in other countries to address the root issue.
Coming up next for us on News 11's Early Edition, it's a gesture a local nonprofit does every year for National